I was telling someone yesterday, Marshall Yonge has been back for a month or two working out and just getting the opportunity to meet with him and talk to him. I mean, he probably doesn't say he knows me, but it's just a great opportunity to learn from some of the best. You get to talk to guys like Riley Reiff when he comes back, when other guys, Julian Vandervelde and Matt Tobin, and then even James Farron. I mean, it's just a great opportunity to learn from some of the best that go through here. And it's once a Hawkeye, always a Hawkeye kind of mentality that when you leave, you're still part of it. In essence, you come back and you mentor guys. You tell them a little bit about the life they're living in case you get the opportunity to go to that next level. So it's great to be part of that Hawkeye family and even more specific Hawkeye offensive line.
Who are you mentoring now? I mean, has this helped you? Who's under you now? Or what are some guys that are your help?
Yeah, Cole Crossan, he's very promising. He's put on a little bit more weight. He'd be the first to tell you that. But he came in pretty small, and he's doing a great job. Ryan Ward, he's from the Chicago neck of the woods. His brother plays at Northwestern. They're both good guys that I'm trying to be a positive influence on. You'd have to ask them if I'm getting it done. But I try to, I mean, I don't know everything by any means. I've been around the block a time or two being my fifth year senior, so having that opportunity to help them, it's great that you're looked up as a role model, and that's what I'm just trying to do on a daily basis.
What do you do specifically to help them? Is it everything? Is it from field, off the field? Is it, do you mentor them in all areas?
I think, first of all, you lead by example. You work hard every day. And then you pull them aside. Say during a practice, if they did something wrong, you notice, you just simply encourage them and tell them what to do. And for the most part, they all respect you. They understand that I've been around for a while. I know the system, not inside and out, but a lot of it. And you pull them aside, you watch tape with them, and you encourage them along the way. I mean, they're going through those growing pains with young guys. And I was fortunate. I had Zeus there. Kyle Hageman was also there for a couple of years. I'm sure there's great guys that I looked up to when I was there, and hopefully I'm doing the same to these guys. But like I said, you have to have someone who needs a job done.
When you came to Iowa, was the dream to play at the NFL level, or is that something that builds while you're in college?
When you're running around as a little kid, everyone always asks, what's your dream job? And a lot of us, it's to play NFL football. But it doesn't really hit in until, over time at Iowa, you understand that once you're started, the possibility is there to play at the next level. Yeah, it's the ultimate goal. Right now, however, we're just focused on improving our season from last year and bouncing back from that disappointing season. So we're just taking one day at a time, and if that opportunity comes to play at the next level, we'll run with it and try to make the most of it. Appreciate it.
Is there anybody that you look at on the offensive side of the ball that, okay, maybe right now they're not getting well-publicized or talked about much, but you feel by the time the season ends we're going to be talking about them like come November or early December?
I think there's a couple wide receivers. I'm not going to mention any names, but I think there's a couple that shined. You guys know just as well as I did in the spring game and throughout spring ball. I'm not sure which one's going to step up and be the name. Obviously, you got Kevontae, Don Shumpert, Jordan Cotton that are going to be impact players for us. But I think there's going to be someone at the receiver position that's going to step up, and their name's going to get out there, and we'll be happy for them because they've all been working hard.
How's it been just being able to have some sort of cohesion along the offensive line? Because obviously you're going into your senior year. You have Brandon entering his junior year. You have Austin, I guess, is really the only one that's making a position change. But outside of that, it seems like everybody's had some sort of playing experience before.
Yeah, that's going to be very beneficial. And we need to use that as an advantage. We need a lead. We need to set the pace. And we have the capability of doing that since everything starts up front with the offensive and defensive line. And we're going to take that into our own hands. We're going to come out every day. We need to be consistent. We can't have those moments of high and moments of low. We need to be steady and consistent across the board. A lot of us have experience. Now we just have to use that experience and make it a successful year.
How's it been for you being here in Chicago and getting this opportunity along with James and Christian?
Yeah, it's been a great opportunity. Last night we sat down with some of the Michigan players, and it was fun just to interact, see what they go through, see how our programs are similar, see how they're different, and just share information with them. It was very good to get to know them and also just experience the Chicago life, the Big Ten media. It's a lot of fun, and it's an honor to represent the university.
When you got in here, did you find yourself thinking back to your win over Northern Illinois? Like, anything that maybe that you remembered about the trip the last time you guys were here?
Yeah, I drove in this time, but when I came in for the Northern Illinois game, obviously I was on the bus. So you get to soak up a little bit more when you're on the bus.
Right.
Driving in the city is a little intense. But, it brings back memories, and that's what's awesome about Division I football. There's a lot of memories, some good, some bad. For the most part, all are good, though. That was a great win for us, and we get to open the season with them, which will be another great game. They're a great team, and we're looking forward to it.
Just along those lines, since you brought up playing them again here this year, do you think that maybe adds more motivation, more fuel to the fire when you're going through the offseason, knowing that your first game is going against a team that you're not only familiar with, but they're coming off arguably the best season that they've ever had, and they return to the guys that they do?
Yeah, they're a great team, and you don't want to take anything away from them. They got a great quarterback, I know, and a great defensive unit as well, and some good skill position as well as line guys. And it's going to be a great battle. They had a great year, and hats off to them. They got a point in the Orange Bowl, I believe, which is awesome, I mean, for anybody. And it's exciting, and we're looking forward to it. We don't have an asterisk next to anyone on the calendar. We're just taking day by day and game by game. So when that time comes to focus on them, we'll be ready to.
If there's one major reason why you feel your offense should or will perform better this year than it did a year ago, what would it be?
I think a year or two in the system is going to be beneficial. We got a lot more experience from guys. Obviously, we're going to be young in a couple positions, quarterback. We got Mark Wiseman, Damon Bullock, Jordan Canzieri back at running back, and some good receivers that I feel have matured over the years. And then also the offensive line. We got a lot of guys back from injury, Sheriff and Denial. That'll be a huge asset for the team. And then just getting comfortable with the system. I mean, that's not an excuse for why our season was disappointing last year by any means. We just didn't play well. But we're looking forward to it. We want to get that bad taste out of our mouth.